Verse 1 to 17. I read, a great sun appeared in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and a crown of 12 stars over her head. She was pregnant and cried in pain, as she was about to give birth. Then another sign appeared in heaven, an enormous red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns, with 7 crowns on its head. The tail swept a third of the stars out of the sky and flung them to the earth. The dragon stood in front of the woman who was about to give birth, so that it might devour a child the moment she was born. She gave birth to a male son, a son who will control the nation with an iron scepter. This child was snatched up to God and to his throne, while the woman fled into the wilderness to a place prepared for her by God, that she might be taken care of for 1,260 days. Then war broke out in heaven. Mighty and his angels fought against the dragon, and the dragon and his angels fought back, but they wasn't strong enough, so they lost their place in heaven. The great dragon was hauled down. That ancient serpent called the devil, or Satan, that led the whole world astray, was hauled down. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven say, now have come the salvation and the power and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his Messiah. For the accuser of our brothers and sisters, who accuses them before God day and night, have been hauled down. They trampled over him by the power of the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. They do not love their life so much as to shrink from death. They therefore rejoice now, heaven, and you who dwell in it. But woe to the earth and the sea, for the devil has gone down before you. He is full of his fury, because he knows that the time is short. When the dragon saw that he had been all down to the earth, he pursued the woman who had given birth to the male child. And the woman was given the 2 wings of a great eagle, so that she might fly into the place prepared for her by God in the wilderness, that she might be taken care of for a time, times and half a time, out of the reach of the serpent. Then the serpent spilled out water out of his mouth like a river, so that it might sweep the woman away with the torrent. But the earth kept the woman by opening his mouth and swallowing the river that the serpent had spilled out from his mouth. The dragon was enraged at the woman and went off to wage war against the rest of her offspring, those who keep God's commands and keep God's part their testimony about it. So thank you.
Hallelujah.
Oye ki soro. Oye ki tu soro. Sherry, memory verse, go kai. Fumi, ba o lefun.
Oh, ba ti mu pe mommy e. Won ni o lo church pe won se rehearsal against
Ijowo.
Ni ano, ano. It started around 6. Church o lo church on Sunday. It came around 6 p.m. So mommy ni pe ba kan ko bele won ni ku so le se, o ni o ma try. So now,
oh, as a matter of truth, our meeting over, come, don't go, come. Our meeting were under the scholarship of the Sunday school. Number one, any kid here, who know, am I boy, you know, cut at 6 classes, not all including, I am so proud of them. Our one job, we want to leave here. Kafia ye ba our Sunday school teachers lati ko o le nira o le lu won won le ba won ri sugbon iba wi ye o ni ere to mu wa oluwa be ma ran wa lowo e se pupo
God bless you, I'm so much amazed. Brother, oh no, Sister Aluatoyi now. Where is she? When I was here for the children harvest, my brother said, hey, I'm really more lonely. Because there are two people who actually recited that day. One could recite very well, but because Moriputi and Tolore, to Mameshe, to Siko Siko, she's purple. But she, for Lore,
My name is Sister Toyin Bushola. I am here to tell you what I understand by this name. Only maybe, to my own understanding, only maybe, I think that only maybe should be celebrated. I think that only maybe should be celebrated. When a prophet then when Sata gave a spiritual name, the hymn number 7. Can you see?
And they get that.
That hymn was given to us on 1947. After the hymn was sung, 30 years later, the pastor in the church saw himself clapping a number of steps until he got to a plain full of falling leaves and sighted a fair lady, and sighted a fair white lady, dressed from top to toe in blue apparel, and standing in a post as if she shaded something away from him. Then the pastor saw himself descending steps. Until he sighted the church, for which a reverend came out and bowed down to him and homage, said repeatedly. Then the pastor saw himself descending again back to the spot where he had earlier saw the fair lady. Then the fair lady opened up what she was shooting away from, was a baby having a crown on his head. And she said, pointing to the baby, just so you, a mini morning, or come morning, or by the baby. Any bad facing, I come up tomorrow to get this. Then the pastor realized that the fair lady was only maybe. Then she repeated the injunction of the song. Jesu, any money, or come money, or buy me any. Any bad facing, Jesu, I come up tomorrow to get this. Then the fair lady told the pastor that it should be made undoubted by the color of his skin, that weight is of no significance in terms of the spirit. Then he told that she added, which means it is because of claim that we dwell in you. Then the pastor, almost a year later, the pastor felt it when he had the revelation about Holy Mary. And it was revealed to him due that he did not recognize Holy Mary Day. And the pastor declared first Friday of July as Holy Mary Day to be observed by full congregational service throughout the world, all over the celestial.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As I told you, not to go quick, You see, the bar poor photo Canada every day. Only Papa so quick. A sin, you come a shame, yes, sin. A sin, Kiku. Oh, sherry, no more Friday. Oh, tea, I come a shame, sin. Everybody, a sin, Kiku. I don't want to pay any talk, compromise, she needs to keep them. Now, what would you mean? Wash it, you bought. Ọpọlọpọ ọkọ ìjọba lọtí gbàǹsì ààrẹ ìdúgbọ́lọ́ ọlọ́pàá ọlọ́pàá pàtí gbà ògbò ni fún kristi lókè ọ̀run.
Àìlè!
Nítorí náà ẹ jẹ́ ká kọ́ àwọn ọmọ wa ká fi àyè sílẹ̀ láti kọ́ wọn. Nítorí àwọn náà ló jẹ́ pé tó bá dojú ọ̀la ká bá rí wọn tí wọ́n ṣe àwọn nǹkan tí ó yàtọ̀. A lè máa sọ pé àdúrà bábá lè máa dùn pé nítòótọ́ ó dá ta fi mọ́lẹ̀ fún ọlọ́run olóògbé kan wà pẹ̀lú wa ẹ̀mí láti ṣe bẹ́ẹ̀ gẹ́gẹ́ yóò fi jogún fún wa ẹgbẹ́ bá mi tó pàdé ọ̀bùn lẹ́kọ̀ọ́ sí ẹ tó ń bọ̀.
But there's one more thing I would encourage you to wait, listen to the Yoko. My worry, you want to damage you. Don't worry, don't stop. One thing I wanted to add is in your recitation, Act Life, it's as if you're reading and too concentrated. When you add life, you look at Brother Isaiah, although he didn't have too much time to have practiced like both of you, but when you did the other one and this very one, you're too much of.
I think we
need. Please add more life. Maybe when you see this and Lagos State quiz competition and spelling, we have seen a lot of them. They add life. Even when they're talking, they say, you know, they add life. Just add life. Don't be too. Just feel yourself and flow.
Thank you.
Both of them want to go no other. I don't know why.